2018. We're at 4150 Catherine in Dearborn Heights. We're going to do a diagnostic televise of the sanitary sewer. You can see we're right behind the furnace. The sanitary is behind the return ductwork. You can see we have the sanitary on the left and the storm on the right. The sewer does go out to the backyard. We're going to begin at this time.
Yeah, this is sanitary. And where do you think they lie up?
Right here. Right here. See it 3 feet here as we turn down? See how we're coming into the branch of the Y?
Okay.
So this line coming behind us is what picks up the storm drain.
So I'm looking forward, right?
Yes. Yep.
Okay.
And now we're going towards the left side. This is the combination line. This is still the cast iron. And you can see just about 8 feet we change over to the 6-inch clay tile.
Yeah, so right here is that the clay tile right there?
Yep, the clay tile is actually, see here's the end of the cast iron right here.
Cast iron's here and then
all that's clay tile. You can see how we kind of drop down a little because it's 6 inch.
So 8 into 6.
4 into 6. 4 inch cast iron. 6-inch clay.
So the actual line doesn't appear to be too clogged at this point.
No, not at all. You can see the two lines where that's the water flow area down there on the bottom.
Okay. Because this shares stormwater.
That's actually not a joint, that's what we call a circumferential crack, because it goes all the way around the tile.
I need to understand that. Okay. So, could you explain that again to me?
Okay,
so,
it's called a circumferential crack because it goes around the tile. No. A crack that goes along the long axis of the tile would be called longitudinal. See, we have a crack there.
Could you see it right there,
and then see if I move a little closer, you can see. Again, it's a.
So this is the joint, right? Is this the joint in the
no, the joint's right up here.
The joint is up there.
Yep.
So this is just cracked here.
Yep.
I was expecting to see a little bit more material, but the flow wall would wash it away.
Yeah. As long as there's a decent pitch to the sewer, most of the time you don't have a buildup of waste and paper.
What's right there?
Well, we're coming up to that's another joint. The clay tile's in 3-foot sections.
Okay.
Thank you. bit. You can see up on the sides there, we have a little bit of calcite that's building up in the joint. It's just some mineral deposits. Say it's probably at least 10 to 12 because it's handling storm and sanitary.
So when this house was built, these houses had the downspouts connected to go under the basement, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they tied into the existing drain tile system. Yeah, now a lot of the houses, a lot of municipalities, they've had those.
So-called clean reason why the storm water was routed into the wastewater?
No, that I don't know why they did. I know the disconnection, not the connection.
The connection reasons were, according to the city engineer, they said they were worried, late 20s or 30s when these were done, they were worried that there would be not enough water to flow. So they added the storm water to help flow the wastewater.
Oh boy.
Oh boy, right? Who would have thought going forward in time?
Yeah, they would need to disconnect to try and eliminate the flow.
Yeah, reduce the amount of water going to the water treatment plants.
Yeah.
And that's what I was told. Now, I don't have any documents on that. That was the reason why the stormwater was connected and
in a way I could see that theory way back when the building was not quite as prevalent as it is now. The same with the population line.
So the main there's too much storm water coming in.
Okay. Yeah, it would be hard to understand why you would be having backup issues. Not like we have tree roots or anything like that. I don't see any large calcium deposits.
That's just
build up over time.
Mm-hmm. cast iron that you can see, correct?
No, no. So as far as, you know, if you said, hey, why would I be